everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Okay, I am continuing on with a look and playing with some beautiful Charlotte Tilbury products. So if you're interested, hang tight and let's do this. For those of you who are wondering, I will have a review up for what is on my face right prior to this, which is a whole bunch of products, but two of the major ones are the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Foundation and the Hollywood Flawless Filter. I tried out a bunch of this stuff too, but those are the two main ones. To start off with, I'd like to give a shout out in this video to Diana Gonzalez. Mwah! Hi Diana! I'd like to say thank you so much for always watching my videos, for leaving lovely comments, constructive comments. I really appreciate it because I always know that, you know, you're right there. There's nothing I love more than, you know, having you guys interact with me. And sometimes it takes me a couple days, sometimes a week, like, you know, with this Jaclyn Hill videos I did, because that was a lot of work and editing and recording and stuff. It took up so much time, but I always get back to you guys, and I love reading your comments so much. So thank you so much. And Diana, thank you so much for being a subscriber and an important part of our channel. Mwah, love ya. Of course, you guys all know, probably if you followed me for long, I love Charlotte Tilbury's products. Love them. Been using them on my channel since the very beginning of my channel. So I already owned quite a few, but I purchased more so that I could do a, you know, I just wanted to do a one brand get ready with me type thing. And of course, I just got done purchasing several items that were new to me, and she came out with more products. So the new eyeshadow palette, the berry colored one that's gorgeous that she just released, I don't have that one, just came out with it. Her Pillow Talk collection, I missed the entire collection because it sold out of my cart, I kid you not. Had it in my cart and it sold out of my cart. I've never been angrier in my life. Her new powder and concealer I don't have. I used the ones that I had purchased for this video because I purchased these items like a couple months ago, so before those had released. So if you're kind of wondering why you're seeing her older palette here or older palettes, it's because I had purchased the stuff planning the video several months ago before everything new released. So, what I'd like to go over with you first is, look at the pretty packaging. Nordstrom's always boxes stuff up for me. So pretty. They're so good to me. I want to get out all the palettes that I purchased to add to my collection and just show them to you real quick. And then I'll decide which one I want to do. So, the first one I picked up is an, oh, duh. They come packaged like, I'm not going to show you the packaging on every one of them, but standard Charlotte Tilbury packaging. And let me look real quick because I do not remember the price. Now, these are now available at Sephora as well as Nordstrom's and Beautylish and Charlotte Tilbury herself. Okay, her palettes, the ones I'm going to show you right now, are $53 a piece. Each one of them is a quad. The first one we're going to start off with is the Rock Chick. I really wanted this. This reminds me very much of a Tom Ford palette that I want, which I believe is called Titanium Smoke. Anyways, and for those of you that don't know, Charlotte Tilbury used to work as the creative director, I believe, for Tom Ford. So her quads and stuff are very similar. Okay, so here is the Rock Chick. Gorgeous. Look at that. Isn't she beautiful? If you like a cool tone eye look, this is your palette. And I'll show it to you the way it is in the palette instead of upside down. It's a beautiful, beautiful palette. Oh, it's just gorgeous. And then I have the Dolce Vita. Excuse the mess in this one already because I've already used this one. I couldn't wait. So there is the Dolce Vita. Then we have the Rock Chick. This one, I wanted this one so bad. Are you kidding me? Did I purchase two of these? I'll tell you, sometimes I wonder where my brain's at. I wanted it so bad. I just told you I wanted it so bad when I showed it to you the first time, and yet I took it out to show it to you again. So obviously, I wanted it so bad, I purchased it twice. Okay, and then we have the Sophisticate. I can't believe I did that. I'll tell you. And this is a beautiful, beautiful palette. This is, I think, her first all matte palette. I don't think she's ever done an all matte palette until this one. I could be mistaken, but I don't think so. And then I have, oh, here it is. Nordstrom's does such a beautiful job of packaging stuff for me, and they really do. They send stuff to me just absolutely beautifully packaged. This is a collection I purchased, and I purchased one for you guys as well. This is no longer available. This is called the Smoky Bedroom Eye Set. So it comes with the palette Fallen Angel, which is no longer available, in her Rockin' Kohl Iconic Liquid Pencil, I believe, in black. Comes in beautiful packaging here. Yee-hoo, boy, oh boy, oh boy, I'm so excited to see this. And there she be. So there's the palette and the pencil, and let's take a look at the palette first. Now this palette, because it was a limited edition palette, is different than her others. Let me show you here. Standard packaging for Charlotte Tilbury Quads is this. The Fallen Angel has decorative stars, and she's got a thing for stars. Interesting. And let's take a look at this palette. Oh God, she's beauty. Oh, she's a beauty. And this has stars imprinted, the same stars imprinted on each of the shadows. So that is the Fallen Angel Quad. And like I said, I purchased one for me and one for you guys. Now, I've never tried one of her eye pencils before. This will be the first time. It's just your standard. Oh, that's nice and smooth and very black, so I'm anxious to try that. Actually, I wonder if I should keep it in that, because on the back it has the actual collection. I'll tell you, the collection I want more than anything. Is Tom Ford's last collection. I searched high and low for that. I had my people at Nordstrom's looking for it. I want that collection so bad. So if anybody sees it or has an extra one they want to sell, please let me know. I want that collection so bad. Okay, now moving along, I also purchased three new colors from her lip cheat. This one is Iconic Nude. Her lip pencils are some of the best that there are. They're some of the best. They just are. That's Iconic Nude. And then we have Savage Rose. They really are incredible. There's Savage Rose. They're smooth, they don't bleed, they hold your lip in beautifully. And this one is my all-time favorite one. I bought this as a replacement, which is Pillow Talk right there. That's technically her most famous lip liner right there is the Pillow Talk. Now I did buy one of her lipsticks. I'm kind of wishing I didn't purchase this color, to be honest with you. This is from her KISSING line, and I purchased the shade Penelope Pink, which is just a little, I just think it's too pale for me, but I'm going to try it out. I just think it's just a little bit, I don't know. We'll give it a try. This is the only lipstick I have of Charlotte Tilbury. So, and I purchased a replacement. If you've watched any of my hauls before, Charlotte Tilbury hauls, I did a huge one where I bought several color chameleons. I love these. This is Bronzed Garnet. I purchased this as a replacement. These are the smoothest. I mean, watch this. I mean, they are incredible. You're looking for just a one and done quick look. You can take one of her color chameleons, just blend it on the eyelid, take your finger, pat it out a little bit, and you've got a beautiful out the door look. I mean, I'm not kidding. Now, I also, you know what, let's get going. Let me show you the one last eyeshadow palette that I purchased that's new to me. This is her first one she released in this large format. These are $75 for the big ones. And she just released a brand new one that, of course, I want really bad, but it'll probably sell out before You know, I live on a budget, so I have to, I budget how much I can spend on cosmetics. Anyways, beautiful packaging. I think this is the one I want to use today because I have not had the opportunity to use this one yet. And each one of these is set up in trios for looks, or you can just have your way with it however you want. But it's a beautiful palette. Now, this one here is very neutral toned. I do not know if this is still available or not. I think Charlotte needs to stop with the limited edition. She just needs to make these things permanent in her collection. I'm telling you, nothing bothers me more than when I go to try and get a product and it's limited edition and sold out because they didn't make enough of them to meet the demand. That just chaps me. Okay, first off, I want to start off with her Face Sculpt and Highlight. This is one of my favorite products of hers. Beautiful tones in this, and of course, beautiful packaging that Charlotte is known for. I've been using this for quite a while, so I have a darn good feel of it and know how it performs and love it. So I am actually going to take my Tom Ford bronzer brush, which is my all-time favorite bronzer brush, and I'm going to go into the Sculpt shade here. Okay. This is a beautiful product. It truly is. If you're looking for a nice powder sculpting product, this is beautiful. Truly. And I believe she has a couple different shades in this now, if I'm not mistaken. And I know she has, this one comes with a highlight, but I know she has one that comes with a blush now, if I'm not mistaken. I know I saw it at the Nordstrom's, I think it was Nordstrom's anniversary sale when I was there, I saw it. And I wanted to purchase it, I really wanted it, because I loved the blush, but I thought, you know, I had just purchased this palette, so I thought, nah, I can't do that. I wish she had come out with something else in that duo besides the identical shade that's in this Sculpt palette, you know, because if she had, I would have purchased it. There's one thing I don't like doing is buying multiples of things if I don't need them, you know. Okay, and then I am going to take, I think I'll just, oh, that's nice, my Wayne Goss, look at my Wayne Goss fan brush. I don't know if you guys can see it, but it looks like it's grown whiskers on both sides here. That's nice. Well, I hope I can get that back into shape. I'm going to take the highlighter here and just hit the tops of my cheeky bones. This is a beautiful highlighter that's in here. And it's light enough for my skin tone, which is wonderful. Gives a beautiful glow. But it's not overabundance, you know? I think so many highlighters on the market anymore are just, they're going for, you know, the biggest glow. And I just, you know, it's not my thing, but it might be somebody else's. Hopefully I'm going to have to wet this and see if I can get it back into its sleeve and reset it, because that is not good. Okay, and I'm going to use one of her Cheek to Chic blushes. Comes in the same exterior packaging, but the compact is different, that it is solid maroon. And here is the color of this one, which is Love Glow. Love Glow! I'm just going to take a, this is a Luxie Duo Fiber Powder Brush 516, and I'm going to go around the outside, because what you're supposed to do is go around the outside and do that for here, and then the inside is the pop right there. So, let's try that. Now, these are beautiful. They really are. She really knows how to make a beautiful powder product. And I am going to go a little heavier than I normally would because I'm going to be buffing afterwards, which clearly is going to take a lot of the color down. So I apply my blush and stuff like that a lot heavier than I normally would. Okay, now I'm going to go in the middle in the pop. And I believe the pop has a little glow to it. You can see my blush looks really heavy in the the little screen things. Like, holy cow, it's not that heavy. It's heavy, but it's not that heavy. There, I look kind of Santa Claus, Mrs. Santa Clausy. These are beautiful, though. They really, truly are. Like I said, Charlotte's powder products are, bar none, some of my favorite. Now, I'm going to go back to my favorite, my Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder. And I'm going to take my Morphe E41. This is what I use for buffing. And I'm just literally going to put a little on and buff all this in. I was tired of my lady. You see how that not only blends everything in, but dials it way down? But see, if I didn't put my blush and my contour and stuff, if I didn't put those on heavier before I did this buffing, if I just put them on normal like I would if, when I wasn't buffing, and then I buffed in, all of that would just disappear under the buffing for the most part. So you do have to, you want to layer up a little bit if you're going to buff, in my opinion. Now watch this. I mean, it just makes such a difference. Beautiful, beautiful difference when you buff in. And you can do it with any powder that you like, you know, like my Lancôme powder, the Pêche or whatever the heck it's called. I just bought another one of those because they were getting rid of them. But this is my favorite powder for that because it just blends everything together beautifully. Look at that. See? Okay, now I think the palette, I'm going to use this big palette. I'm trying to figure out what color to use out of this. Again, there are the colors. It's kind of hard to see with a reflection, but beautiful, beautiful palette. Her new palette has a real strong berry tone to it. I want it so bad. So bad. That and the Tom Ford collection I missed. Oh my god, it came with a beautiful palette and two lipsticks. I tried so hard to find it. Ugh. I think I'm just going to stick with what's called the Desk Eye. I might zooze it up with something else, but this is the Desk Eye. I might put a little bit of this in, but I'm going to start with this one here. So, on my Wayne Goss 03, I'm going to take the center brown shade of the Desk Eye here. And I'm just going to do... Oh, wait, it would help if you blend in and set your eyeballs first, dingbat. Hang on. I'm setting my eyes with the Airbrush Flawless Finish as well. There's nothing more beautiful that a powder can go on than that. Okay, back to this center brown shade here. And I'm not going to do anything, I don't want to do anything wild today because I'm going out, I have errands to run and grocery store and that kind of stuff. So I don't want to go out looking wacky doodle, you know? So I'm just going to put on just a nice average eye, if you will. Or try and keep it that way. With me, you never know. Start off one way, end up another. I'll tell you one thing I love about her eyeshadows that clearly she picked up in her time working with Tom Ford, or for Tom Ford, if you will, is how beautifully they blend. I mean, you did not have to work to blend these shadows at all. My color balance looks totally off. I don't look orange. Why do I look orange? Look at that. It's really strange. Okay, now I'm going to grab my Wayne Goss 19 and I'm going to go into the next darker one here on the Desk Eye. Or I should say the darkest matte shadow. Wow, look at that pigment. I was not ready for that. Like that surprised me. Of a favorite song. So wash it. Yeah, I'm back to my other Wayne Goss brush and just blend that out. Bed. And in the personal columns, there was this letter I read. Rain really hard. They just blend beautifully. They really do. If you're not into yoga, if you have half a brain, you're not having to deal with bunch of fallout on his face. And in the dunes on the Cape, and I'm the love that you've looked for. Write to me and escape. And now I'm going to take my Wingoss 06 and go into the very lightest shade in the palette here and put that under my brow and use that to blend in this top color. Doesn't seem to be very pigmented. It seems more like it's used just for a base, if you will, you know, to blend out like I'm doing here. Kind of as a corrector shadow rather than a pigmented shadow. I'm going to take my Wingoss 20 and I'm going to go back into that first shade I used, the lighter brown, and put that all under my eyes, both of them. And then I'm going to go a little bit into the darkest brown, just on the outside corner here. I didn't think about my lady. I know that sounds kind of mean. But me and my old lady have fallen into the same old old routine. So I wrote to the paper. And now I'm taking a Wingoss 03 with that white lightest shade and just ghosting that under here to really blend and diffuse out. I really think that is a diffuse color, that white shade in here. I don't think it's meant to be a pigmented shadow. Okay, let's see here. These are very finely milled. I mean, very, very finely milled. So they are a little powdery in the pan. I think I'm going to go into Date Eye and use this center shade. And I'm going to take, let's see, what is this? My Wingoss number 18. Let's see if I can pick it up on that. Dry first. Let's see what she does. Oh, holy cow. Pick up she does. Look at that, you guys. Look at that. I'm telling you, Charlotte Tilbury makes some absolutely beautiful shadows. I mean, the fact that that picks up like that and I have no adhesive, no glue, no special base, nothing. Look at that. Beautiful color, too. Look at that. I can't even describe that color. It's very unique. It's like a gray-brown with some champagne in it. It's very pretty. And then I think I'm going to take the Disco Eye. There's a real light one right there in Disco Eye that I just dug my nail into. God, I hate when I do that. And I'm just going to take that and tap that right along my lash line, right in the center there to give it an extra... Ooh, look at that. Boy, I hope you guys can see this. Because that is gorgeous. Look at how that just zazzed that up right in the middle there. Oh, that's beautiful. And see, the other thing, this tells you right here how beautiful quality these are, not only because of the way that they apply, but the fact that when I put those metallics on, if you compare the way they look on my lids to the Jaclyn Hill metallics, it's like night and day. These don't look heavy, build up, crusty, thick on my lids. I'm going to take that same shade right on the inner corner here. These look smooth, soft, beautiful. There's a big difference. Huge difference. And I know there's a big price difference. So we don't have to state the obvious that I know there's a big price difference. But I also know that you don't have to have a $75 palette to produce a beautiful eyeshadow. I mean, you can, or a beautiful metallic. You can look at Juvia's Place as an example and know that. Their metallics are absolutely stunning. I'm just going to buff this in here, really buff it in the corner here so that I can bring out as much shine as possible. Okay. Look at that. All those colors. Gorgeous. Back to my Wayne Goss 04, back into the darkest color in that palette. Or in the desk eye, excuse me. And I'm just going to blend this right into the edge here. And very softly. Right there. Love it, love it, love it. Okay, if you can still get this palette, I highly recommend it. Otherwise, I would highly recommend you get a hold of her new one that just released. Like I said, I'm desperate for it, but I know what's gonna happen. See, I stick to a budget. I only allow myself so much per time period for my makeup. And if I get to that, then I stop. I don't say, well, I'm just going to get this. I'm just going to get that. Otherwise, I'd never stop. I reached my budget, and that released, and I literally wanted to cry. Because I know it'll be sold out by the time my budget renews, if you will. Okay. I want to try her eyeliner real quick, too, because like I said, I have not tried her eyeliner. I've tried everything else. The chameleon sticks and stuff, but I've never tried her eyeliner. So what I want to do first is I'm going to curl my lashes so I don't muck up the eyeliner afterwards. Okay, so I'm going to take this one, which is black, I believe, and I'm just going to take it right along the lash line here. I thought it wasn't half bad. Yes, I like pina coladas. And then I'm just going to take this Bodyography Pro Angled Liner brush and smudge this out a little because I don't want it so harsh. See how it blends. Blends real nice. Of course, you guys know me, I love my Pat McGrath Permagel. Eyeliner's my all-time favorite pencil liner. But this blends real nice. I'm not sure how these do in the waterline. And just a tiny bit, I think I want to put right here too. Should have done this before my eyeshadow, but oh well. I want to connect it. And I think I want to put this in my waterline too, even though this is really going to deepen up the whole look. See what I mean? I do it every time I say I'm going to do a light look and look at what I do. Okay, now all we need is lips and lashes. So I think I'm going to do Pillow Talk because I'm worried if I use Iconic Nude, it's going to be just too cold with that lip color. These lip liners are the best. They smooth over the lips with no issue. They're creamy. Mind you, I haven't tried Pat McGrath's yet either, though. We all know how much I love Pat, how much I love her products. And I'm going to feather this in a little. Hope that it gives this color a little life. I don't know why I picked a color this pale, because I never wear them, but hopefully it'll look good with this eye look since it's a little more dramatic. You know what I think it is I don't like is the yellow in it. Yep. That's the yellow in it. Because I just don't like yellow-based anything. Doesn't look good on me because I don't know if it's my neutral tone that I have to my skin or what, but I just find that yellow anything just doesn't look good on me. She came out with a brand new mascara, the Legendary Lashes 2, which I forgot to purchase. Hang on. This is the mini of her original formula, which was just the Legendary Lashes. So, look at that. Isn't it cute? But she has a new formula, Legendary Lashes 2, that is supposed to be better than this one. That is not supposed to smudge and stuff, which was the biggest complaint with this one. So I'm just going to put a little of this on just to darken my lashes. And I think I'm going to put lashes on for this look. What the hell? Nordstrom's treats me so good. It's a keychain. Has a little, her little star on it, and then the lips with a cigarette. Not that I'll ever use it, but it's cute. Okay. Let's see here. I am going to put on which lashes? Hang on, let me find them. I think I'm going to put on the Flutter lashes. I love these. I really wish they would do this again. It's at Makeup Shayla Limited Edition by Flutter. I have not been able to find these. I just absolutely love them though. So if anybody sees these or knows where I can get them, please do pass it along to me because I love them. Okay, I'm going to put these on. I'll be right back. Okay, lashes are on. I don't wear them very often, but I sure love these ones. Now I'm going to take a little MAC Extended Play Giga Black lash for my bottom lashes. This is a beautiful mascara to get those little lashes on the bottom. It's not a builder mascara, but it is definitely a grab-on, get everything defined mascara. And then if you want to build them up and make them, oh, I just gouged my eye. That was brilliant. But then if you want to build them up, you know, you can grab one of your thickening mascaras and go over after they've dried from this one, because this gives beautiful definition and length. It gets right in there to the lash line. I've been using this mascara for years and I love it. I wish they would come out more than anything. MAC, please come out with this in waterproof. If they released a waterproof version of this, I would never put it down. No joke. I love it that much, but because of the fact that it's not waterproof, my eyes tend to water and I can't wear them as often. Okay, so let's see. Of course, I just smeared it underneath my eye. That was beautiful. Yeah, I'm not sure what I think about that lip color, but there she be. There's the finished look. What do you guys think? I'll tell you one thing, I love Charlotte Tilbury's eyeshadows. Absolutely love them. I don't think there's a product of Charlotte Tilbury's that I don't like. The only thing I've tried of hers I don't like, correct that, is that one if you watched the first video where I did the foundation, it was that self-adjusting thing because it just didn't work. I'm going to try this. It doesn't feel like there's anything in here. I purchased one of these with my Morphe order, I forgot to tell you guys, and I also purchased two of their cream lipsticks and the Wink Wink and Whipped. I'll show those another time, but I want to try this. I totally forgot. Wow, that's got fragrance in it. Holy cow. But you know, it just goes to show you the bias people have, because I cannot count the number of people that I've heard say that this is their all-time favorite setting mist. They love this more than anything. They'll never use another one, blah, blah, blah. And then I see them sit down and even put on a blush and complain that the blush has fragrance in it. Or a lipstick. I wish they wouldn't put fragrance in our lipstick. I wish they wouldn't put fragrance in our foundations. This smells like I'm spraying perfume on my face. I'm joking, you guys. I love the mist. But wow, the fragrance in this is absolutely strong. Funny thing is, it's the last ingredient, but wow. That's like blow me away strong. Funny how those same people complain about fragrances in their cosmetic products, but they're spraying that on their face. And when you're spraying, I almost have to want to hold my breath because it's so fragrant. But we'll see how it works. After I sprayed it, it seems to have meshed everything together really nicely. And it certainly brought out the glow. But as usual, if the products are available, I will put them down in the description box for you. I would greatly appreciate it if you do want to purchase any of these products. If you see something you like, I'd be beyond grateful if you would use my link down below to purchase it. The only thing it does, straight up transparency. Remember my hat? Transparency. It does not change the price of the product you buy. It doesn't tracking information on you. It doesn't do anything except for give me a very, very small portion of the sale. And by small portion, I mean, I think I get 5%, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong, but I think it's 5%. So anyways, and that's in every video. If you see links down in the description box that have a little asterisk by them, and I have that written down in my description box too, so there's full disclosure. Any link that has an asterisk by it is one that I will receive a small portion of the sale. Small portion of the sale if you use that link to purchase the product. So I'm just saying, you know, I'm not going to push codes and links and stuff on here. I just want to let you know that if you do see something in this video or any other that you want to purchase, I'd really appreciate it if you would use my link, because it's no different you going to Sephora directly as using the link that I've provided for you. And it takes time to do all those. I'm telling you, it takes me hours to do all those links in a video like this. So it's nice if people use them if you want to get the product, especially since it gives me just a tiny little bit that helps to build another avenue that I can earn a little bit of money to purchase products. Because as you guys know, until I reach 1,000 subscribers and I have 4,000 hours of view time, I can't even apply for my channel to be monetized again. I was monetized at one time until they changed the rules. So, you know, everything that I expend on all this comes out of my pocket. You know, I don't get stuff for free. I don't, very rarely. And I don't have any means to earn anything on my channel except for those links right now. So, and if you guys like what I'm doing here, I'd really appreciate it if, you know, if you tell people about my channel, or when you comment, if you see a video, like you see a Morphe video or something, and, you know, tag Morphe in it, or, well, that's not a good example, but you know what I mean. You tag the company I'm talking about in it and say, you know, tell them you should check out this reviewer, you know. It helps just to spread the word about my channel so that, you know, people learn about me, because I'm such a small channel. And if I can get to that 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of view time on here, then, you know, I can, just to breach that threshold, for one thing, I have a killer giveaway I'm so anxious to do. I've been waiting to do it for months and months and months. But another thing, you know, it's a big threshold for me to get to 1,000. It's my goal right now, and I'm really working hard to try and achieve that. So anyways, I appreciate you guys' support. Enough about that. I've got some great products coming. I've got stuff from Linda Hallberg Cosmetics, my first time ever showing or experiencing her products on my channel. I've got stuff from the wonderful and great Pat McGrath coming up. I've got Natasha Denona's new palette coming up. I've got the Grand Pro palette coming up from Viseart. I have the Melt Cosmetics Gemini palette coming up. The Gingerbread palette from Too Faced, as you guys know, and if you can't tell, I am a eyeshadow junkie. So got a lot of them coming up. Anyways, so stay tuned for that, and I might even sneak a little giveaway in there too. Wink, wink. I love you guys. I hope wherever you're at in the world, life is treating you well. And if you're having struggles, you're beating the bitches back and persevering. Don't ever give up. Don't ever give in. Don't ever let anyone tell you no. Everyone gets discouraged. Everyone does. And you know, one of you, I forget your name and I'm so sorry, I'll have to look in the comments, but one of you left me a comment saying that you are a college student and the message at the end of my video really struck home for you and gave you a boost, what I had to say. And I want to tell you something right now. First off, thank you so much for the lovely comment. And secondly, just know that everybody goes through hard times. Everybody goes through struggles. Everybody faces challenges in life. It doesn't make you weak. It doesn't make you less than. It doesn't make you, you know, you compare yourself to your best friend and you look at them, or you compare yourself to this person or that person. Just remember, you have no idea what's going on behind closed doors, truly. And everybody has struggles. Everybody has problems they have to deal with, and issues they have to face, and family problems and problems in school. But it's even more compounded when you're young. And if you're young out there and you're having struggles and you're having a hard time and you're thinking, why? How can I do this? Just know this. Hang on. just hang on. Because you know what? I swear to you, the older you get, the easier it gets. It really, truly does. So don't give up. Don't give in. You just keep chugging along and know that the reward will be so worth it, because 5-10 years from now, you'll look back and you'll think, thank God I hung on. Okay? And you'll hopefully remember me saying this right now. You'll think back to this time when you heard me say this. So I love you guys. And until next time, remember, when you're out in the world, treat those you encounter with love and respect, because they, like you, have feelings and can be hurt too. Till next time, bye!